This Medical Minute, sponsored by Avera.
Checkup can be an awkward and confusing experience. Dr. Catherine Schiltz is joining us to offer some suggestions to help calm some nerves and help prepare your daughter for her first well woman exam. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
All right, I think a good place to start is, what is a well woman exam?
Yeah, it's really an introduction to lay a foundation for like a healthy lifestyle. So in an adolescent, it's getting their foot in the door to talk about, you know, specific concerns, but also just well-rounded healthcare and what to expect as they grow and continue to develop.
Yeah, when's a good time for a teen to start having or thinking about having this well woman exam?
I think at any point they have concerns or they don't feel comfortable talking about their concerns at home or with a pediatrician or primary care provider that they've been seeing forever. And or if there's just things that maybe a parent is noticing or they're just interested. I see a lot of adolescents between 13 and 15 for their first visit.
Yeah, how great can that be to have that, you know, person to talk to if sometimes maybe you don't want to talk to your parents about certain things?
Absolutely. I think some of the stuff they're dealing with is uncomfortable and it's not a topic of conversation for the dinner table. And so having a trusted provider that they feel comfortable sharing with their concerns or questions really puts them at ease.
Yeah, and I guess, you know, what will happen when they do their first well woman exam? What can people expect?
Yeah, you know, I think there's gonna be a lot of questions. So what's your health been like up until this point? Have you had surgeries? Do you take medications? Do you take supplements? Are you involved in activities and sports? Have you gotten your first period? Do you have problems with your periods? Are you having pain anywhere? Do you have breast concerns? In terms of examination, I think the most intimidating part is girls think they have to have a pelvic exam or a breast exam, and that's not the case. That's only when it's indicated and made through shared decision making. A lot of times we're gonna listen to heart and lungs and do an abdominal exam.
Yeah, and if, you know, teens have maybe some nerves, how can parents maybe help calm those nerves a little bit?
Yeah, you know, I think it's lovely for a mom to take her daughter to her own provider so she can say, I've met this person, they're great, I have a relationship with them, you know, they're gonna take very good care of you. I think, you know, mom can be in the room. They're there for a lot of the visit. I leave that up to the patient, but they can certainly be there to help put them at ease too.
Yeah. Anything else people should know about these exams before they go?
Yeah, you know, not really. I think just coming with a general list of questions or concerns is the big thing and just getting your foot in the door. So when problems do come up, you have access to a provider that can help and just, you know, a good, like, lay the foundation for what to expect. Mm-hmm. As an adolescent, there might not be that much, but as you grow into your 20s and 30s, everything is evolving. And so you kind of know what's up and coming.
Yeah. Well, thank you for being here. Appreciate it.
Yeah. Thank you for having me.
And we'll be back after the break. And for more information on this topic, you can head over to avera.org/medicalminute.